Welcome to another episode of the Microprocessors course. In this episode, I will teach you the 8086 internal architecture. Before going to know about the internal architecture in detail, let them see here the 8086 IC. This is the 8086 IC which comprises of 40 pins. Dual inline package. Dual inline package means that this is the first pin and second pin, like that the pins are going to be increased up to 20th at this side. This 20th pin will be treated as a ground pin. And this is 21, and from the 21 to it is 22 and it is 23, like that it goes on, and it is 40th pin. The VCC is connected to the 40th pin actually. It is powered up with the plus 5 volts power supply, which comprises of 29,000 transistors are involved in the 8086 microprocessor. By the way, this 8086 microprocessor, which was manufactured by the Intel company during the period of 78 and 79. This is the simple history of the 8086 microprocessor. Now the today's topic is internal architecture of 8086. This 8086 comprises of two functional units. One is bus interface unit and second one is the execution unit. This is the entire microprocessor which is having a two units. Of course, we have a memory interface which is connected to the microprocessor. In addition to that, we also connect input device as well as output device. The instructions are coming from the memory devices to the bus interface unit. In the bus interface unit, we have some very important parts like a dedicated adder or address summer or a summer, whatever it is the name. The name is not important, but the point is that it generates a 20-bit address using this adder. You can similar ALU will be find here, but this is not used for ALU operations. This is only used for adding purpose to generate a 20-bit address only, and this ALU will be used for arithmetic logical unit purposes. Now, in the bus interface unit, one adder will be provided here, and we have a 4 segment registers like extra segment register, code segment register, and the stack segment register, and data segment register. These are the registers pointed to segments to access the particular memory location and particular segment. So if you want to access the code segment, we can use the code segment register to point out the code segment memory locations. Like that, you can use the data segment register and stack segment register, extra segment register may be used for accessing the particular memory segments. Here another register is instruction pointer register, which is used for executing the next, what is the next instruction is going to be executed, that tells by the instruction pointer. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 registers are used here. And we have a 6 bytes long queue provided, and it is operated with the principle of FIFO. Whereas in the 8085 microprocessor, the queue was not there. In the 8085 microprocessor, queue was not there. Instead of the queue, there is a instruction register. So replaced by the instruction register in the 8086 microprocessor, we have a queue in the processor, particularly in bus interface unit. So 6 bytes long of the instructions can be stored into the queue. So the prefetched instructions are stored into the queue. So the main units in the bus interface unit is, the microprocessor can be divided into two units. One is a bus interface unit and second one is a execution unit that we have already seen. In bus interface unit, adder will be there as well as queue provided as well as registers provided, like code segment, data segment, extra segment, and stack segment, and instruction pointer. These are the main units which are involved in the bus interface unit. In the execution unit, we have an arithmetic logic unit and control system. Coming to the control system, the internal operations can be made and can be performed by using this control system. Along with that, there may be a chance to send the address as well as the data for reading and writing operations. Control system can be used. In the control system, we have a decoder unit. The function of this decoder unit is that the number of instructions can be translated into sequence of steps. So the instructions are translated into sequence of steps. So then the decoder will decides what is the action to be taken for executing the instruction. So after decoding will be done, then it is sent to the execution unit. So execution unit is ready, always ready to take the instructions from the queue. And we have some general purpose registers like AX, BX and CX and DX. Along with that, stack pointer and base pointer is also used for accessing the stack. As well as some index register like SI and DI, source index register and destination index register, which is used for string manipulations and to access the data segment and extra segment also. So these are the offset registers we are using in the execution registers. And arithmetic logic unit, we have addition and subtraction and multiplication and division. Along with that, we have some shifting operations like left shift and right shift and looping operations. All the functions can be performed by the ALU. After performing the ALU operations, there may be a chance to get the result. In the result, you can see the flags. What are the flags affected, like overflow flag affected or sign flag affected, zero flag affected, parity flag affected or auxiliary flag affected. Like that we can see some of the conditional flags and unconditional flags. Later we will see elaborately all these things. So when you see this block diagram, you have some little bit idea about the architecture. Now we will go through the each and every section, how this architecture has been designed and what are the functions been happened in the every section of the subunit, in bus interface unit as well as in execution unit.